Hi everyone, my name is Mike Fitz with explore.org. Joining me is Felicia Jimenez, a park ranger who works for Katmai National Park in Alaska. And welcome to our video series for Fat Bear Week in the Classroom. The questions we are answering now were submitted in advance, and thanks to everybody who submitted their questions. Katmai National Park is a great place to live if you are a bear. And in this video, we're going to talk about the tough bears found in Katmai. So Felicia, the first question I have for you comes from Layla in Mr. Leslie's fifth grade class at Grandview, who asks, what species of bears do you have in your park?
At Katmai National Park, we have coastal brown bears. They're essentially the same as grizzly bears, but these bears get their name because of the coastal resources that they're utilizing. So they eat salmon is a really big part of their diet. So salmon come and run up through the river, Brooks River, and this is the majority of what bears are eating in Katmai versus a grizzly bear who eats mostly plants or berries. They're going to be located a little further inland. So a grizzly bear and a coastal brown bear are the same. It just depends on where they're located and what they're eating. So the bears that we're looking at are coastal brown bears.
So we know that many brown bears live in Katmai, but do we know actually how many? Aubrey, who is in fourth grade at Clarkston Elementary, and Fiona, who is also in fourth grade at Montgomery Elementary, both asked how many brown bears live in Katmai.
So Katmai is a really big park. There are over 4 million acres in Katmai National Park, and we have over 2,000 brown bears estimated in the park area.
Finally, each bear is unique, and we have a special opportunity to get to know bears at Brooks River as individual animals. They're all bears, but they can behave differently. And Quinn from Accelerated Schools asks a question related to this. Do the bears have different vocalizations, and can you look at that as an acquired or an inherited characteristic?
Yeah, so bears have different vocalizations depending on what message they're trying to tell other bears. One good example is Bear 128 Grazer. Whenever she is with cubs, she's actually considered a very fierce bear. And so, you know, if a different bear comes too close to her cubs, she might vocalize and make some either huffing noises to show that she is, you know, upset, back away. She might even make like the typical like bear growl noise that you might think of as a warning, like go away. Like I've given you that huffing noise as like a first, you know, warning. Now I'm like actually mad at you, go away. And you know, I'm not sure about inherited characteristics because bears make many different kinds of sounds depending on the situation that they're in. So you just have to listen to, you know, what the bear, the context around what the bear is saying, what message they want to give out. Body language is also a good thing to look at when you're thinking about vocalizations in bears.
All right, well, the only species of bear in Katmai is the brown bear, but Katmai National Park as one of the largest populations of brown bears found anywhere. And each bear is a unique individual too. So you can discover that by watching them closely. Thanks for listening, everybody. Be sure to look for our other videos for Fat Bear Week in the Classroom and watch the bears of Katmai on live webcams at explore.org/bears. If you are a teacher, then along with watching this program and the live cams at explore.org, be sure to check out the Brown Bear Extension activities that you can find on Katmai's website at nps.gov/katm.